There is something about middle children, especially large families. They often struggle to define themselves. Robert Francis Kennedy was the ultimate middle child. Until shortly before his untimely death 50 years ago, he was still embarked on that struggle of self-determination. Kennedy's early career included working as an aged staff member for the right-wing demagogue Sen. Joseph McCarthy. It would have been reasonable to conclude that a young conservative could only move further right at aged. Kennedy turned the table on the conventional wisdom by moving, both by circumstance and by calculation, in a more liberal direction. But it was a distinctive liberalism that was shaped by its origins in a family that, despite their enormous wealth, were regarded as outsiders. I'm a political scientist who studies American government and U.S. legislative politics, and I've worked as an advisor to Democrats in the Senate and House. It is clear to me that Robert, much more than his older brother John, was shaped by the tribalism of Massachusetts politics in the 1950s. From tribalism via religion to liberalism for all of their money and effort to cultivate the wealth what signed was affluence, the Kennedys were scorned by the first families of Massachusetts the way any group with long established wealth regard parvenu. And it wasn't just their Irish heritage that placed them at the margin of elite best state society, it was their Catholicism. Of all of the four Kennedy brothers, Robert was the most emphatically Catholic. The Kennedy family in 1931. Robert is on the left in a dark sweater, Richard Sears, John F. Kennedy Presidential Library and the Museum via Wikimedia Commons struggling to distinguish himself in his sprawling family, all clamoring for attention from their father, Joseph P. Kennedy, Robert sought out his mother, Rose, who took her religion seriously. Competitiveness within the family also bred in him a combativeness that could verge on harshness that he struggled, sometimes unsuccessfully, to control. He made an early enemy of Senate Democratic leader Lyndon B. Johnson, while a junior staff member, by publicly rebuking Johnson. A former staff and myself, I remain astonished at such boldness, even from a Kennedy. Robert worked tirelessly to promote the political fortune of his brother Jack, first in his campaign for the House and then, in 1952, when he challenged Henry Cabot Lodge for the U.S. Senate. It was this campaign in which Joe McCarthy intervened to boost Jack's candidacy. McCarthy, a Kennedy family friend, prevailed on the Republican Senate Campaign Committee to go easy on Jack and do a little a possible to help fellow Republican Lodge. Bobby's role as staff member on McCarthy's Senate subcommittee on investigation would have caused the casual observer to mark him a rising right-winger. Added to that was his service a counsel to Sen. John McClellan's investigation of corruption in American Labor Union, and his conservative credentials were cemented. The transformation the change in Kennedy came with his controversial appointment a turned general in the administration of his brother at a time of great tumult in race relations. the criticism was that the appointment smacked of nepotism and that Kennedy was unqualified for the position. President Kennedy's flip response was, he can't see that it's wrong to give him a little legal experience before he goes out to practice law. It was the era of the Freedom Riders, the mostly African-American young people who boarded bus to the South to challenge segregation. Their confrontation with local authorities often led to violence. Kennedy's initial reaction was that this order made the United States and his brother the president look bad in the eyes of the world, hardly the reaction of a bred-in-the-bone liberal. Also, his first dealings with Martin Luther King Jr. were tense. Kennedy also raised FBI surveillance of King, saying, he's not a serious person. If the country knew what we know about King's grandson, be finished, King, for his part, resented having to ask Kennedy for help. But ultimately, Kennedy's experience dealing with the resistance of Southern governors to racial integration caused him to sympathize with the struggle for equality. He also recognized the importance to the Democratic Party of the black vote in the North, especially in presidential elections. After his brother John's assassination, Robert Kennedy left the Justice Department and ran for senator in New York. He won, and during this period, his embrace of the plight of minorities broadened to include Mexican farm workers in their struggle to unionize. Kennedy embraced civil rights late in his career. He remit with civil rights leader at the White House in 1963. A Bureau of National Parks Service, JFK Presidential Library and Museum in 1968, en battle démocratique President Lyndon Johnson declined to seek re-election in the wake of almost losing the New Hampshire primary to challenger Eugene McCarthy, the liberal anti-war Minnesota senator. Kennedy then joined the RAS, belatedly and reluctantly. He ran to seek new policies, said Kennedy at his announcement. Policies to end the bloodshed in Vietnam and inner cities. Policies to close the gap that now exists between black and white, between rich and poor, between young and old, in this country and around the rest of the world, while he shared McCarthy's opposition to the Vietnam War. Kennedy emphasized the need to combat racial injustice and economic inequality. His appeal to minority voters broadened, especially after his eloquent impromptu eulogy to the doctor. In Indianapolis endowed Kennedy with an exalted status even among the most alienated African Americans. Kennedy's own death, assassinated right after he won the California Democratic primary just a few months after King's, was a crushing blow to Americans who sought to right the wrongs of the nation both domestically and in the larger world. Americans hopeful for change were leaderless. Man rejected conventional politics and sought solutions in radical movement, in drugs, and in the panacea of false prophets. For those who stayed in the fight, Kennedy's belated embrace of social justice was readily forgiven. Ross Baker, distinguished professor of political science, Rutgers University. This article was originally published on The Conversation.